controversial Russian academic Immanuel Velikovsky believed that events in the heavens caused the great biblical catastrophes. At the time, his ideas were dismissed as fanciful nonsense by NASA. But a few scientists are revisiting Velikovsky's theories. It is now accepted that apocalyptic events on Earth, including mass extinctions, have been caused by astronomical events.
Velikovsky may have been wrong on the specifics, but he may have been right about a comet catastrophe affecting Earth.
People did indeed believe in ancient societies that the advent of a comet was an omen. Maybe there was a grain of truth to what those people were thinking.
In 2007, a group of six scientists from America, Australia, and Russia suggest a possible link between the flood story in the Bible and the crashing into the Earth of a large comet which hit the Indian Ocean 5,000 years ago.
The impact of this comet would have had devastating consequences. I mean, it could have created 600-foot waves. I mean, these are mega tsunamis that would have wiped out civilizations along shorelines and devastated entire communities.
The group claims to find evidence of a giant wave that swept miles over the land. Some even suggest that this comet impact might explain the 40 days and 40 nights of rain described in the Bible.
That impact would have thrown up a vast amount of moisture, of debris, into the atmosphere.
Velikovsky also thought that the planet Venus caused the great plagues of Egypt. Now some scientists believe that killer plagues may well originate in space.
Although Velikovsky was wrong in asserting that pandemics came from Venus, he was certainly right in saying that pandemics came from space. They came from comets.
Space is populated, some scientists now believe, with extraterrestrial life forms, which, if they reach Earth, can enter and infect humans.
If that's the case, what we're dealing with is extraterrestrial virus, and that is extremely frightening.
Alien life forms carried by comets may be the cause of some of the most tragic events in human history.
The idea that comets bring death is very clearly written in the record of pandemics, of diseases, of epidemiology, like the Great Plague of Athens, like the Plague of Justinian in the early Christian era.
Our ancient ancestors saw the appearance of a comet as a worrying sign of some impending disaster. Some astronomers are finally accepting that there may be reasoning behind this apparent superstition.
The importance of Velikovsky is that he alerted the world to the fact that the Earth is vulnerable, vulnerable to the tails of comets.
Angry gods or alien disease hitching a ride on comets. One thing's certain, there's more cosmic trouble heading our way.
It's gonna happen, and when it does, we better watch out.
July 20th. 1969, Apollo 11 touches down on the moon.
The Eagle has landed.
Bringing with it the very first humans to step foot on another world.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
On that very first mission, astronauts Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin encounter something that remains to this day unexplained.
There was a kind of a bright cloud existing for many minutes.
Aldrin described this strange glow on the moon's surface as brighter than anything he could see in either direction. Scientists are baffled.
What are these things? I don't know. Maybe we're not right about the moon being completely dead.
Despite being our closest celestial neighbor, there is much about the moon that is shrouded in mystery. In total, humans have only spent 80 hours on the moon. We have made a superficial inspection only of a tiny fraction of the surface, and the dark side remains a mystery. But almost 40 years after Armstrong's mission, a lunar probe launched by India, the Chandrayaan-1, lands on the surface of the moon. On board is NASA's moon mineralogy mapper, and it makes an astonishing discovery.
In 2018, NASA announced definitive proof from their mineralogy mapper of water on the moon.
I mean, we've been looking for water for years, decades, till finally we looked in the right place in the right way and found it.
Water is the elixir of the cosmos. Where there is water, there is very possibly life.
Ever since the end of the Apollo program in 1972, we've been wondering, should we go back to the moon? Is it worth returning?
This discovery is a real lunar game changer.
But it's not just the possibility of life on the moon. In space, water is fuel.
Today, we have a modern day gold rush. Not for gold, but for water. Because in space, water is gold.
Experts now fear a deadly stampede to conquer the moon. In August 2018, a NASA probe discovers the seemingly impossible: water on the surface of the moon. And this can't be water that has arrived from icy comet impacts.
Any water that may have been delivered to the moon, it should have evaporated right into space.
There's no atmosphere there to help trap it, and so it basically escapes.
And yet the NASA probe has mapped out billions of gallons of water on the lunar surface.
At the polar regions, there are locations where sunlight never reaches, especially because there are deep craters there. And within those craters are places called permanently shadowed regions. In those locations, ice can remain there for billions of years.
Scientists now have an astonishing theory as to where this ice has come from.
A plausible way for there to be water at the permanently shadowed regions is that it actually escaped out of the moon.
This could finally explain the mysterious mist encountered by the Apollo astronauts.
If it's gas coming out of the interior, one of the most likely components could be water. So you have water escaping out of the interior of the moon today. And that's really exciting.
It's possible that vast quantities of water may now exist deep within the moon, a remnant of the time when it was a hot and geologically active world. And this water escapes to the surface as gas.
To find any sort of water on the surface of any world besides Earth is a huge, huge discovery. Discovering water on the moon is like discovering gold, except it's much, much more valuable than that.